My name is Kaylin Sutton, a student athletic training student at, damn, I said student athletic training student. Good morning, my name is Kaylin, athletic training student at Seton Hall University.
I'm Jason, I'm a student athletic trainer at Seton Hall University.
And today we'll be talking about scapular retraction. Scapula is located in the back, so Jason turns around here. We have the medial border of our scap right in there, and I feel Jason's inferior border right there. So retraction is when Jason holds his arms out in front. Now bring your shoulders back, Jason. Scapular retraction is when you bring those scapular blades, those medial blades, in. Okay, so that's what we're going to be working on today. Primarily, the muscles that we use for scapular retraction are the middle fibers of the trapezius and the rhomboids major and minor. And also, that motion that I just showed you takes place in the transverse plane for the range of motion. So first, we're going to go through an isometric exercise. So Jason actually kind of already demonstrated the isometric exercise, but we're working with an athlete or a patient. We're going to have you do it again. So actually turn around, Jason, so they see in the video. Now hold your arms straight out in front comfortably. Yep.
Side.
Or actually, yeah, let's do it from the side. So Jason, hold your arms out comfortably like that. And now you're just going to bring your shoulders back. And before you start, go back to start position. So usually when I instruct the patient, we'll do about 10 reps, and on each rep we're going to hold for 5 seconds. So go ahead, arms out in front, and begin. One, hold, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Go ahead, start. And again, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Again, and 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Yeah.
And we repeat for 10.
Yes, so we would do that usually around 3 sets of 10, just so the patient get a nice workout in. So that was the isometric exercise. Next we move on to isotonic. Isotonic is when you have a concentric and eccentric contraction of the muscles. So first we're gonna work on our open kinetic chain isotonic exercise, which is going to be the, remind me again, Jason, the bent over flies, yep. So with these, we're gonna use weights. And depending on patient comfortability, we can have Jason either seated or standing. So what do you feel most comfortable with, Jason?
I'll go seated.
Seated.
Now.
So we have a physio ball Jason's going to use for the seated. And I'm going to hand these weights to you, Jason.
Thank you.
And just for instruction, since Jason is sitting, we want to make sure he's sitting with his back straight, chest out. Now, he's going to lean forward slightly, so we want to make sure when he leans, he doesn't have excessive curvature in his back is a straight plane. So for the movement, we're doing the same movement, retraction of the scapula blades, just with weight. So on my count, you're not going to hold Jason at the top, you're just going to do one rep and come back down.
Okay.
All right, and begin. One, good. Two, good. Three, good. Four, good. One more. And five, good. And just like with the isometric exercise, we will also do around 3 sets of 10, just so that Jason, or working with another athlete, they would feel the effects of the workout. Next, we're going to do a isotonic closed kinetic chain workout. And for that, we'll actually go outside and use one of the machines to show you that. So this is our row machine here, and before we start, we want to make sure that the athlete or patient is aligned with the machine, or that the machine is aligned with the patient, so that they're able to do the exercise properly. So first, with this chest pad, we want to make sure that it's at the length at the top of the sternum. We also want to make sure that it's out far enough, because you can adjust it in or out. We want to make sure it's out enough so that if he lifts his arms straight up, it lifts him to the point where the handles are. Just at the handles, so that when he lifts the weight and brings it back down, they don't touch. So we already have them set, so we have the weight set comfortably for Jason. So remember, keep your head up, chest out, and go ahead and decide which grip you want to use. And go ahead and begin. We'll do 5 reps. 1, good. 2, and if the camera comes around, if he's doing the same action, yeah, he can come around. He's doing
the exact same action, if you look at his scap, those medial borders are coming in. So that middle fibers of the trapezius and the rhomboids major and minor are concentrically contracting when he brings his arms back. And as his arms go forward, they're eccentrically contracting.
So next, we're going to do a functional exercise that really works scapular retraction. So for that, we're going to do a chest pass with basketball. Because if you think about a chest pass from the side, bringing the ball back, and those scaps are definitely retracting as I bring the ball back, and you come out. So here, I'm doing my concentric contraction. When I bring the arms out, those muscles, the rhomboids major, minor, the middle fibers of the trap are eccentrically contracted. So for a patient who's coming back from an injury or muscle strain for those muscle fibers, this would be very helpful, especially if their sport is basketball. So we're gonna step out about 10 feet or so. That's good right there. And we're gonna work on the chest pass. So step one, two.
Kalen Sutton.
I'm Jason Huberman.
And thank you for allowing us to teach you scapular retraction.